Hey guys, it's John here with Greenfish Nation. Guys, I want to thank you for joining us on the channel today. Guys, we're out at a little East Texas lake here near the city of Canton, Texas, called Mill Creek Lake. We're in the fall transition months right now. It's mid-September. We're going to get out here and try them out and see what we can do. If you've never fished this lake, there is a $25 a year permit fee, or if you just want to try it for a day, it's $5. That can be picked up at the police department off of 243 West here in Canton. However, if you're a first responder, a member of the fire, EMS, or police department, that year permit's free. So guys, stay tuned here. We're going to get out here on Mill Creek and see what we can't put in the boat. Tight lines, y'all. Our water temperature is about 79.5 degrees today. I got a northeast wind at about 5 to 7 miles an hour. Just putting a little ripple on the water here that you can see. We're gonna start out right here close and cast around these docks and see what we can figure out. Like I said, water temperature is about 79 degrees. We had our first little cool front the other day. I'm excited to get in here and try them out. We're trying to get all of our graphs and stuff set up here where we can have a little side imaging, a little down imaging. I think I'm gonna start out with a moving bait. I like to try to cover as much water as I can. I'm gonna try to turn this camera in just a little bit. I think that should be good right there. Start out with a little moving bait. You're gonna throw a chatter bait. We're gonna spend a few hours out here today. This lake has got some deep water in it, 20 foot or so. The state has put some of those artificial brush piles up in different locations. I'm not 100% sure where those are, but I am gonna get my phone out in a little while and look those up. But for right now, I'm just gonna fish like I always do. I'm just gonna kind of beat the banks and see what I can come up with. We'll see what we can figure out here on Mill Creek today. Showing lots of cover and junk under the water here. I've been gone a while. I apologize for that. I've been busy doing paramedic things, and as you guys know, my wife and I were in the middle of building a new house. I've been fishing that knucklehead series with KBF, and really been concentrating more on fishing than filming so I could make that national championship with KBF in October. We're going down there October the 1st, I believe. I'm gonna fish, I believe it's the 6th and 7th, or 5th and 6th. Anyway, first weekend in October, we're gonna fish a little knucklehead challenge series. I got four other anglers that made my team. Rob New, I got a father and son out of Oklahoma, Chris Payo and his dad. I believe I'm saying his name right. And then I've got another gentleman out of South Texas, Daniel. We'll just call him Daniel W. Daniel, I won't butcher up your name until I talk with you and I learn how to say it. It seems like it might be of Polish descent or something, so I don't want to butcher that up. But anyway, we're looking forward to going down there and having a good time. But today, we're going to spend a day out here on this beautiful lake, Mill Creek. 79 degree water, lightly stained, which it generally always is. That's what happens when you have sandy bottom with a little bit of iron ore in the water. Water's clear down to I got about 3 foot of visibility. My buddy Dylan, he's on his way out here. We just both worked a 48-hour shift on the Amlets, and we're looking forward to some nobody needing us time so we can repair our hearts and our minds out here on the water. That's what he and I both enjoy doing. So we're going to give it a shot and see what we can come up with. I see a few fish jumping out there. They might be chasing shad. We'll have to check it out. I did change, for all those of you guys that have been following me for the last couple years that I've been on the kayak, I did change from a PWM back to a just a switch on my trolling motor. Was having issues since I moved up to this 62-pound thrust motor of overheating the PWMs, and I couldn't get but about maybe a quarter of a mile trolling at full steam with that, and that kind of made it hard to fish tournaments and get back to the boat ramp in time. So I elected to go with this switch. We're going to give it a try, and if that don't work, I guess we're going to just have to bite the bullet and buy an NK180 or a 300 and just call it good. I was just trying to use what I had. I'm happy with it. I know I could get a little bit more speed out of a NK180 or a NK300, but I could get a little bit more baloney with using what I had. I wouldn't have to spend that $1,200 or $1,400 on a motor, and then another couple hundred dollars on a motor mount, and then another $700 or $800 on a battery. So I'm trying to use what I got
with a marker.
I got a printer. We can print you out some little stickers and stick on there. I got it in my truck, actually.
Yeah, I need to get the handle first and then put it on the outside of it.
Yeah.
Bird.
Oh, bird.
Different test mate.
Yep. Done picked up now. All right, there's number one.
Hey, yeah, they're in here. I just fished over there too.
See if he'll make the tournament. Oh yeah. Is 13 inches. right here on this corner right here. He's going to make the cut, though. Got to be 12 inches. He ain't going to make 12. But he was fun to catch. Well, guys, I think that's going to about wrap it up here for Mill Creek. We didn't do as good as we hoped, but we've done better than nothing. We caught a couple. We got to put one on the board on the Tyler Reels Fishing for the Texas region. So he wasn't a giant, but he was 13 and a quarter. So thank y'all for joining us here on Greenfish Nation. Tight lines, guys.